North Korea has tested a new solid-fuel intercontinental ballistic missile on Friday in a bid to boost its nuclear counter-attack capability. Pyongyang warns the Hwasong-18 missile may bring extreme horror to its neighbors. Analysts say this marks the North's first use of solid propellants in a ballistic missile. Meanwhile, China calls for restraint on the Korean Peninsula. The Chinese Foreign Ministry asserts the rising tensions in the region are linked to America's large-scale military exercise in the region. China hopes the parties involved will stay calm as it urges the U.S. to de-escalate the tension. Taiwan holds civil defense drills in its central Taichung city days after China concluded war games around the island. The pre-planned annual series of drills were modified to include elements of warfare amid the conflict in Ukraine and a heightened sense of threat from China. Meanwhile, visiting U.S. Senator John Hoeven expressed his concern over China's aggressive action in a meeting with Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen. He said Washington will continue to provide arms to the self-ruled Democratic Island. Former U.S. President Donald Trump testifies under oath in a New York civil case accusing him and his children of business fraud. The deposition happened behind closed doors and came a week after his historic arraignment on criminal charges in a Manhattan court in his hush money case. The civil case was brought by New York State Attorney General Letitia James, who sued Trump, his children Eric, Donald, and Ivanka for allegedly committing fraud at the Trump Organization. Trump is facing a slew of state, federal, and congressional probes that threaten to complicate his bid to regain the presidency in next year's elections. The U.S. arrests an employee of the Air Force National Guard over the online leak of highly classified documents. The 21-year-old suspect was arrested by FBI agents in Massachusetts. According to a report by the New York Times, Jack Teixeira is the leader of an online group where about 20 to 30 people share their love of guns, racist memes, and video games.
The Justice Department arrested Jack Douglas Teixeira in connection with an investigation into alleged unauthorized removal, retention, and transmission of classified national defense information. He will have an initial appearance at the U.S. District Court for the District of Massachusetts. We will share more information at the appropriate time.
The leak of Intel documents is seen as one of the worst security breaches in the U.S. since the 2013 WikiLeaks scandal. The documents labeled secret and top secret first appeared on social media sites in March. They contain details of military capabilities of some of America's rivals and even allies. As for U.S. President Joe Biden, he says he is not overly concerned about the leak of highly classified U.S. documents. This despite mounting concerns from the international community, with Britain saying there was a serious level of inaccuracy in the information.
There is a full-blown investigation going on, as you know, with the intelligence community and the Justice Department, and they're getting close. I don't have an answer.
Well, we got to move.
I'm not concerned about the leakages, and I'm concerned that it happened. But there's nothing contemporaneous that I'm aware of that is of great consequence.
A powerful storm dubbed Ilsa slams into the northern coast of Western Australia on Thursday. Now, severe tropical cyclone Ilsa crossed the coast near Port Hedland just before midnight as a Category 5 storm. It has since been downgraded to a Category 3, but authorities warn it still has the potential to cause significant damage. Ilsa is the strongest cyclone to hit the region in over two decades. It is packing winds of up to 315 kilometers per hour, breaking the previous record of 194 kilometers per hour brought by Cyclone George in 2007.